Let's talk about vitamin D deficiency, the ignored pandemic. When we're talking about a pandemic, we're talking about a large group of the population worldwide. And I'm not sure if you knew this or not, but there are over 1 billion people on this planet that are either deficient in vitamin D or have vitamin D insufficiency, which means that they might have a subclinical or somewhat of a deficiency, but not a full-blown vitamin D deficiency. But vitamin D is such a necessity for so many biochemical reactions. There's over 200 biochemical reactions. In fact, 5% of the genome is influenced by vitamin D. It's not just involved with bone health and calcium metabolism. It's really important in your immune system, and that's what I want to focus on. Now, these four countries are very deficient in vitamin D: China, India, South America, and the Middle East. And when a woman is pregnant and she's not getting enough sun or eating enough food with vitamin D or not supplementing, she could become very deficient very fast because that baby inside is just sucking the vitamin D for growth and development. Also, if a woman is lactating, that can create a deficiency unless she's taking vitamin D or getting a lot of sun. And infants commonly are vitamin D deficient. Now, if you don't have enough vitamin D, very specific things happen within the immune system. The T helper cells have a difficult time working. Those are the cells that would be equivalent to the general of an army. They're involved with communication and coordination of the entire military team. Also, the T regulatory cells are influenced highly with vitamin D, and these cells prevent autoimmune reactions. They also are involved with suppressing inflammatory responses, especially in the lung. There's a condition called cytokine storm, which is involved in acute respiratory distress syndrome, which is actually killing people with a weak immune system. Without vitamin D, it's very difficult to inhibit this inappropriate immune reaction. So vitamin D is regulating how much inflammation or how little inflammation you need to overcome an infection. Vitamin D also can help to inhibit the iron in certain cells because certain pathogens actually eat the iron. So vitamin D is needed to help to prevent these microbes from getting that iron. Also, there's vitamin D receptors in a lot of immune cells themselves. And one of the purposes of the receptor is to help convert the inactive vitamin D to the active form of vitamin D. Now, there's another player called the macrophage, and this immune cell actually eats garbage, and it also eats viruses and bacteria and other microbes. So vitamin D stimulates the number of macrophages, as well as the pre-macrophage, which is the monocyte, turning into the macrophage. And lastly, vitamin D helps to make antimicrobial weapons. They're called peptides. I just wanted to show you the very important link between having not enough vitamin D and what it potentially can do to your immune system, and the vital importance of using vitamin D as a preventative thing, as well as something you could use if someone is sick or if they have pre-existing health problems. Conditions like cardiovascular disease, high blood pressure, diabetes, obesity, all are vitamin D deficient. If you have friends or family that have these pre-existing health problems, and they're concerned about the virus, get them on vitamin D, especially if they're under critical care. I mean, right now, there's a lot of doctors that are recommending hydroxychloroquine and zinc and an antibiotic, but also add in the vitamin D. Now, I also want to mention how people are deficient in vitamin D. As we get older, it's very difficult to absorb vitamin D, especially in the skin, because the skin becomes thickened. And so when sunlight hits our skin, you just don't get the full capacity of vitamin D conversion like you had when you're in your 20s. The more clothing you have, the more vitamin D deficient. It's very difficult to get vitamin D from your diet. The sun is the best way to get vitamin D, but you also have to be exposed to the sun, so wearing a bunch of clothing is not going to help. The latitude of where you live, the closer you live to the equator, the more vitamin D you could potentially get. People that live in the northern hemisphere typically have lower amounts of vitamin D, excluding the Nordic countries. And that is because they consume a lot of fish. I mean, think about where you would get cod liver oil. It's from that area of the world. The more pollution that you have, the more deficient you're going to be of vitamin D. And this would be a really good evaluation to evaluate the most polluted areas in the world and then look at the outbreaks, the infection rate, and the death rates. I already know in Italy, the most polluted cities have the highest mortality situations. I do know that in Wuhan, China, it's highly polluted. Okay, skin color. What determines the color of a skin is melanin. And melanin actually protects against UV radiation. The darker your skin is, the less vitamin D you're going to be able to absorb. And then we just have the general health of your skin. If you have very unhealthy skin, then you're not going to actually have the capacity to absorb vitamin D. The more sunblock that you use, the less vitamin D. Now, genetics. Yes, there are genetic weaknesses that prevent you from absorbing vitamin D. And that's what I wanted to pause and just talk about this for a second. Polymorphism. What are polymorphisms? Well, we have 63 of them. And basically, they're an alteration or a variation of the vitamin D receptor. If you have an infection, let's say, for example, you have this chronic infection that goes on for months and months, microbes tend to deplete you of vitamin D, both because they block the vitamin D receptor and also because your immune system is needing more vitamin D to work. So the more infections you have or the more chronic an infection is, the more vitamin D you're going to need. And then lastly, if you have malabsorption, for example, if you have gut damage or some inflammatory condition in your gut, that is going to prevent the absorption of vitamin D. If you want more information about vitamin D, I put up a video right here. Check it out.